We separated out the shell design portion in the previous video. For this episode, I'm going to introduce concepts of levels and layers to improve shell design. Before I start with levels and layers though, I left off a change I wanted to make in the previous video, so let's change that first. These two mesh to point nodes here can be unified if moved to Shell Builder. So let's make some space before this group output and insert mesh to points. Next, let's delete the two mesh to points in the fireworks side. It looks a bit cleaner now. As for levels and layers, fireworks can have multiple levels of bursts. Level indicates at which point shell or star was spawned. For example, this firework has a level 0 shell that is launched. The child shell that is spawned from it is level 1, and the last star that splits is level 2. In total, it had 3 levels. Layers indicate the number of different characteristic, shell, or star within a same level has. If you have a star that has different color as shown, you can consider them to be in different layers. So this firework we were working on so far has 2 levels and 1 layer. I will start implementing this concept into fireworks algorithm. First, let's give shell objects proper name with naming conventions. Change plane to shell underscore 0 underscore 1. I'm connecting collection name, level, layer as naming convention. With that, icosphere should now become shell underscore 1 underscore 1. Next, I'm going to add a new attribute in Shell Builder so level of shell objects can be identified from the fireworks node tree. Set type to integer and call it shell level. Pull out a group input and rename it to shell level. Then, from modifier tab, set shell level parameters. Set shell 01 to 0 and shell 11 to 1. Next, let's add a logic in fireworks to automatically detect necessary shell object. Currently, we're directly inserting these shell objects, but I want the logic to select from collection instead. First, delete this object info and replace it with collection info. From the dropdown, select shell. I want this selection to be also controlled externally, so pull out a group input and change the collection to argument. Name it shell object collection. Next, let's realize instance and become able to view its attributes. Connect the output to delete geometry. Then pull out a not equal from selection socket. Compare named attribute shell level with 0 and delete all points that are not of level 0. This should prevent any other points from spawning at the launcher. I know it's a very ugly implementation, but I could not come up with a better one. Alright, let's see the animation. Shell 01 is launching as expected. Next, let's also add an auto detect logic on the shell 11 location as well. In order to do so, we need another runtime attribute, so let's hop into initShellRT. Add a store named attribute with integer type. Call it childLevel. Add one to named attribute cell level and input into value. By doing so, each point will know which level object to spawn next. Exit out with tab and make some space here. Delete the object info, then duplicate these two nodes and bring them over to connect to instance socket. Let's delete the points that we don't want instanced. First, add a delete geometry. Pull out a not equal from selection. Then, compare named attribute shell level and child level. Any points that are not of child level should be deleted. Auto detecting logic is now complete. So let's check out the animation. The first object to be launched is shell01, which specifies a child level object shell11 to spawn. It's not obvious at this point, but we now have ability to add new levels and layers. All we have to do is add objects in shell collection and specify its level. So, let's start off by creating a firework with multiple layers. We will just grab this shell11 object. It is displayed as points now since we moved the mesh to points, but we'll duplicate this object. Then, go into edit mode and scale it down. Tab back out to object mode, then rename. Since it's a second layer in level 1, call it shell12. Let's change the tail lifetime and color so it is distinguishable from shell11. Shorten tail lifetime for shell11 as well so it does not overlap. If we run the animation, you can observe that firework now has two layers. We just made a new variation by adding an object into shell collection. Next, let's try out a multiple level firework. Just to cut corners, I'm going to reuse this shell12 and rename it to shell21. Then, increase the shell level of shell21 by 1. Make sure to set the isShell of shell11 to true, so the object becomes a shell and bursts. Just like that, it is now a multi-level firework. Run the animation. And now, the firework bursts in two levels. So, if we make varieties of shell object collections and set them to launcher, we will be able to end up with different results as just shown. Before we wrap up, I want to make another small change. This bursting speed value of calc init val in fireworks node tree is currently set to 150. However, considering how initial speed of child is determined by the amount of powder used in parent shell, it should be a design parameter for the parent shell. Level 0 powder amount should affect level 1 initial speed, and level 1 amount should affect level 2. Let's add a new store named attribute to Shell Builder. Set the type to float and call it Shell Burst Speed. Add a group input and call its argument Shell Burst Speed. For the parameter settings, set it to 50 for level 0 and 100 for level 1. Level 2 does not burst, so keep it to 0. Next, go to initshellrt in Fireworks and add another store named attribute. Keep it as float and set the name to burst speed. Add named attribute shell burst speed and copy its value to runtime data of burst speed. Lastly, go to calc init val and delete group input. Replace it by named attribute burst speed and plug it into scale. Open up the side panel with N and remove the unnecessary input. Let's run the animation. It's kind of hard to see what changed, so let's change the value a bit more. Let's reduce the shell burst speed to 10 for level 0. Now it looks like this. Let's now increase it to 100. The difference is more obvious. Alright, that's it for this episode. So let's summarize. First, the outliner. There is a new argument for launcher. In shell collection, we've renamed based on new naming convention. There is also a third shell object. Parameter is as follows. Inside Shell Builder, these nodes were added. Inside Fireworks node tree, these auto-detect logics were added. Initshellrt, these new nodes were added. And lastly, for calc init val. We've added a concept of levels and layers. Next, I'll be adding some helper functions and randomness. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.